I am prepared. I am ready. I can do this. Oh, hi. I didn't realize you were back already. I was just, going over a few things to get ready. You probably didn't even realize that you spend a good deal of your time talking to yourself. Whether you are passively absorbing incoming information or actively trying to make decisions, you are often having an internal conversation with yourself. This self-talk is the second PEP skill, the T in BTSF. You've already learned how square breathing can provide you some control over your internal physiology under stress. Self-talk is a strategy to improve your feeling of self-efficacy. Self-efficacy is the belief you have in your own abilities, specifically your ability to meet the challenges ahead of you and complete a task successfully. Self-talk enables you to allocate your concentration and attention appropriately to benefit cognition and the technical execution of tasks. The flexible allocation of mental resources in service of goal-directed behavior is known as cognitive control. Self-talk is a cognitive control strategy that can help you recognize task-irrelevant thoughts and emotions and replace them with task-focused items. With practice, it can improve your perception of control in a threatening situation and boost your confidence. Much of what we know about the application of self-talk strategies comes from the sport and performance psychology literature involving elite high-performing athletes. In addition to their physical training, they rely on self-talk to feed themselves positive suggestions as part of an internal monologue, to remain focused, limit stress, push the limits, and squeeze every drop of talent and ability out under intense pressure. Self-talk is a valuable tool no matter your experience level. Novices in particular use self-talk more frequently and benefit from it more than experts. Experts have more automatic responses and execution of tasks, requiring less cognitive thought, whereas novices tend to talk themselves through things more, especially if the task is new or the conditions different from usual. There are two main types of self-talk, instructional and motivational. During instructional self-talk, you talk your way through procedures. Instructional self-talk helps you chunk information into short directions and assist you in executing possibly complex tasks, like intubation, place in the sniffing position, scissor the jaw open, inch the blade along the tongue, find the epiglottis and lift. Voila. Use instructional self-talk for tasks that are a little less familiar or familiar tasks performed under extraordinary conditions. Motivational self-talk can help you maintain a positive attitude and flexibility even if things start to go awry. Motivational self-talk bolsters your confidence in your ability to perform and rise to the occasion, and a few go-to motivational scripts can counteract negative thoughts. For example, this is an easy procedure. I have been trained to do this. I can get it done. The patient needs me to get it done, and I will do it. If I go slowly, this will be easy. As you learned earlier in this course, your emotional state and beliefs heavily affect how you assess and respond to situations. Motivational self-talk can help you redirect negative thoughts and focus on maintaining a positive and flexible attitude under stress. The final style of self-talk is self-affirmation. This is a highly individualized extension of the above two strategies related to your performance in a particular situation. For example, the difference between "stay focused, I can do this," and "I know I'm good at this procedure, I know my emotional state, I've done this procedure successfully before and will do so again." These affirmations more specifically reassure yourself about performing in a particular situation. Having the cognitive bandwidth to call this skill up under extreme stress will require practicing under more optimal conditions. Current research provides some guidelines for self-talk strategies. In the next exercise, familiarize yourself with these guidelines and follow them to begin developing a script for self-talk.